An entire fire station suspended as 8 firefighters are accused of unprofessional conduct involving alcohol. Tonight, hear from their chief and neighbors about what's being done to protect residents. Here's WLKY Steve Tellier.
They're supposed to be there to, you know, to protect us, to come to everybody's rescue if you need them to, and to know that they're over there partying is kind of scary.
PRP Fire Station 5 was quiet on Friday. The sign out front says volunteers needed, and that's true now more than ever after all 8 firefighters based here were suspended.
We will not tolerate this kind of behavior.
PRP Fire Chief Vincent Smith says the volunteer firefighters violated station policies, including the standards of professional conduct. He says the allegations involve alcohol, but will not go into detail.
Can you elaborate at all? Was there alcohol at the firehouse?
I can't elaborate at all.
Chief Smith says he believes whatever happened was a one-time isolated incident, but stresses that despite the suspensions, safety remains the top priority.
Before we actually made the suspensions, we put in place a plan to ensure our residents that their fire protection would be the same as it was before this happened.
Does that reassure you?
No, but I hope it's true.
A woman who lives nearby didn't want to be identified, but she says Station 5 hosted frequent cookouts.
It's rowdy. They get loud sometimes, sometimes not, but you see koozies, you can't tell what they're drinking.
She figured they were just fundraisers.
We don't think nothing of it because it's the fire department.
Now the fire station nearest to her is effectively abandoned.
It makes me real nervous knowing we're sitting here, and especially during the summer when it's been such a drought and there's nobody there.
Steve Tellier, WLKY News.
And the PRP fire chief says that if anything, their response times will get better. That's because paid firefighters at nearby stations will cover the territory previously covered by the station's 5 volunteers. He says he has forwarded the results of his investigation to the chairwoman of the fire board, who will ultimately decide whether to file formal charges against the 8 firefighters. If that happens, a disciplinary hearing is likely within the next couple of months.